Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I'm continuing with the series of videos I'm recording about the different ML and generative AI services that the different cloud providers offer us. I will talk about Amazon Bedrock. Amazon Bedrock is a fully managed service by Amazon, which provide an API to work with AI, with LLM models. Models that come from third party, commercial and non-commercial third parties, and also models from Amazon. So today we will be covering how to create how to set up the service and also the functionalities or features that you have on the service, and also we will make a small demo on how to use the one of the models that is available on the model repository. If you watch the videos I uploaded before, this is kind of similar to Azure Machine Learning Studio, the model repository, also Azure OpenAI Studio, or similarly as well to what is Gemini Studio, Gemini AI Studio, or Vertex AI. So a little bit behind them, you will see now that there is still some limitations depending on the region where you want to use the service, but well, they are you know, Amazon is a big IT tech, and they are focusing on this for a long time, and well, it's the matter that you will see that is limited, especially in some regions like Europe. Still Europe and Asia are still with limited functionality in terms of using Amazon Bedrock, but you will see that is on the line that the other cloud providers. So I will provide, as usual, a notebook with the documentation, also when some interesting links to you read the documentation to start to introduce a part of what I'm going to explain you here. You can go to the documentation and read in detail how to set up the account, etc. So I am assuming that you already had access to Amazon, that you had your account created, you had how to say, you create your user, you already had as well the CLI set up in your local environment, and all this stuff, because I will not cover this here. I'm assuming that you have it, and this is key to work with this. It's pretty simple to do it. I get you here these 5 bullet points, 5 steps to set up your development environment. And well, if you have any issue, just write me a comment on the video, and I will try to help you to set up. But also, I'm thinking to record a video on how to set up the accounts on the different cloud providers. But well, I suppose that you can manage this yourself. The only real requirement, apart of the setup of the local environment with your AWS CLI, is to have the Boto3 installed. As you know, Boto3 is the SDK to access all the AWS services. So we need Boto3. I make this notebook, this test with Python 10 and the library that I don't know even the we can probably do a test which version I install here, but is the I install it with Conda, so but well, you can take an example here. Okay, what more? So just in this, Amazon Bedrock is the serverless and fully managed service that Amazon offers to work with foundation models. You can personalize models or fine-tuning You can create prompt, you can do rack, you can do many things with the tool. You don't need to worry about infrastructure because everything is working through an API. And then, well, it's very powerful. Again, still, in my opinion, and this take it, make your own evaluation, make your own conclusion. In my opinion, they are still a little bit behind especially Azure or Google provide, but is there, and I'm 100% sure that they will provide something at the same level or even better than the other cloud providers. Okay, so once you have your development environment, go to this link and understand what is available in your region. Is fully available with all the functionalities in the US. But if you are in Asia or Europe, you may not have most of the functionalities, as it's happened with me. I'm in Europe, in United Kingdom, and then most of the functionalities are not available. If you see here my dashboard in Bedrock is a little bit limited. I make anyway this notebook. We will make other notebooks as soon as I get access to the US services. I want to first of all evaluate what is the cost, and because as I mentioned in videos before, you need always to consider data cross-bordering costs and this stuff in order not to have surprises on your invoicing. And then as you can see, the dashboard in the USA, in the States, is much is complete, in few words, in comparison with what we had in the only available region, Frankfurt, in the US Central, where they are providing this service. Once you set up your access, they are recommending you to connect to the US to explore all the functionalities. But again, I will do it once I'm completely sure that it's not going to be a big surprise on the invoicing. One more. Once you have installed it, you need to request access to the models that you want to use. Here, as you see in Frankfurt, in EU Central, we only had access to Amazon Titan, one of the versions, and also Claude Anthropic. This is a model for summarization, and still need to understand what are the limitations to use Claude in this region. But well, for the purpose of this introduction, we will be using Titan. This is an Amazon model, so there is no problems to use it. Just you request access in a matter of less than 1 minute, you will get access. If you are in the States, you have plenty of models available. They are working, you look at the overview, they are working not only with commercial, also with non-commercial, or with free use model like Llama 2 or Mistral, but also with Claude, which is commercial. Titan is at the end is Amazon. You are going to pay by token. All of these models you will be paying by token. The functionalities we will cover, you had the conversational chat box, prompting, and also image similar, something like Gemini Pro, Image Pro, or DALL-E in OpenAI. So this is something similar. I didn't test it. In the next video, we will explore all the functionalities that we will not cover today. This is only an introduction today. So they had functionalities to incorporate data from your own data, like for RAG purposes, and also to create agents style land chain. We need to explore this in detail. Again, we will cover this in a different tutorial. This water mass detention, I look at I oversight what they are doing, and I'm not really sure that this is very interesting option, but very interesting feature. A model evaluation to check your model. This is quite on demand today to verify that your model is not providing answers toxic or answers, and the answers that your LLM produce are accurate, that are worthy, are useful in any case, because it's not you are wasting money. You at the end of the day you pretend to use an LLM to provide useful answers, and obviously without bias or toxicity on them, and also in terms of the activities like or tasks that intend to do some mathematical rational or whatever, some robustness in the inconsistency on the answers. Also, you can introduce reinforcement learning from human feedback in the loop, so also possible. You can fine-tune models here, custom models, so you can do practically everything that you can do. For example, if you watch the videos I uploaded before about foundation models in Azure Machine Learning Studio or OpenAI Studio, Azure OpenAI Studio in Azure, pretty similar. Again, in my opinion, a little bit back from what the Azure, for example, have, or even Google, but they are there. No, you can here as you can see, only. Again, in US, you can create your model. You can customize a model. You can select a model from the available. You can customize a Titan, Cohere, or Meta, a Llama, and personalize a model with one of the available data sets. You can input your data as well here. Yeah, we will cover this in a separate video because it's quite an extensive topic, and yeah, today just an introduction of what is possible to do and not possible to do. So in any case, take a look before start what you have available in your specific location, and try to avoid my advice not to spend additional money asking or sending requests to the US region if you are not located there. Okay, so the only requirement, as I said before, is in my case I just installed Python and I create a Conda environment with Python 3.10, and I installed Boto 3 with Conda. So, and you see here the version. I don't really know if it's the last one or not, but again, it's covering the functionality. We had we connect to us in if you know, if you were before with Boto 3, this is the SDK of the Amazon Web Services, and then with this you connect to every service available on Amazon. So here you just need to specify the service. We are going to use the serverless runtime, but they had this tag, Bedrock runtime, and you specify the region. In order this to work, you have to be created correctly your account, your CLI environment, and also configure correctly your environment. Here, as you say, it's recommended. This is just a copy from the some of the links or some of the in Amazon Bedrock documentation. They recommend to connect to US West 2 because as you see, they had all the services available only in the States, but as you see here as well, it's working at least with this model that we are gonna use in in Frankfurt with this EU central one. Okay, so I create a well some silly prompting just to evaluate the service. It's just you need to prepare a text, the text and some arguments to send to the. So here in this first of all, sorry to go back and forward. Here you create the client to connect to the service. Again, it's a fully managed serverless solution. So you just need to log in correctly in your account in AWS and use it. You just need to understand how to create the prompt or the query to send to the endpoint. And that's it. And then you will see here you create the text, and then you need to create at least these four elements. Is the name of the model, the how you the format of your request, the format of the response, and the body, which minimally or at least you have to include this input text, which is the key. Where you attach your prompt. You take your client, you invoke the model, and you send the parameters, and you receive a response. In the response, you get the in the body key. You will see by default you had only 128 tokens. So, well, let's see. Here we are going to see this. I just send in to create how to create paella. As you may know, I'm in Spanish, and then I can evaluate very well this. Here you see the as we have only 128 tokens, the response that the service sends us is how to say longer, and then on the service just cut off the answer. After 128 tokens, including the prompt, so we see here that we had the completion finish. For those that are familiar with OpenAI, you remember completions and chat. This is the same concept, no? The completion finish because of length. This means that the well, when we get the 420 tokens, the model stop to generate the output. So the output is not finished. We just print it. The output is on the body, on the body key, and in the next answer we just increase the number of tokens, and you can also, like in other services, you just need to go, for example, to the playground, to text, and you will see here, you just select a model, apply, and you see here, these are the typical, the most typical or most relevant parameters that you can send to an LLM to generate text. Okay. Yeah, if you watch the videos I uploaded about Gemini or Vertex AI or Azure Machine Learning Studio, they are pretty similar all of them in terms of what you can configure as parameters and send it to the LLM. They are not reinventing the wheel, because this is how the LLMs can be personalized or query or parameterized when you do a query. Here just we create this, we send the response, and now we will head. So the answer. Okay, so now you have here, and then you see here finish. This means that it creates an answer, and it has enough tokens to answer you with the according to what we are just describing details how to prepare this. Let me take a look what they say. Well, not bad. Well, nobody put chorizo, but okay. Pound it. You make a paella, seafood paella, you don't put chorizo paella. But well, it's I can imagine that they are taking recipes from Anglo-Saxon countries, and then usually in Anglo culture they used to put chorizo in paella, which is not part of the original recipe. But it's fine, no? It's fine. What they say. Okay. Then on, I will make, for example, another activity here that is summarization. It's just create a read a text, a transcription of a conversation, and just create another prompt and just send it as well to the endpoint. We are using again Amazon Titan Text Express V1. This is a small model. You can get the description here. Amazon Titan Express. Yeah. This Amazon model already built from them, and then well, it's not working bad, eh? It's not working very bad, it's fine. So you can just make the summarization. Then you can try with your own samples. And now we use embeddings. They are also producing embeddings, which for some, especially for RAC or document similarity, some other use cases. Yeah, you just send again to the model is slightly different. You can look at here, there is embeddings and text models. And then it creates a vector of 1536 dimensions. And then input at 800 tokens, which is not bad. This is very long context window. And then on, we just send to the model, and you have it here. Okay, that's all. I will prepare other models. I know that probably you are more familiar with SageMaker, which is the service that is operating in Amazon for a long time already, probably more than 6 years at least. I don't really remember when I get in touch with the SageMaker long ago. And then this is the service is how to say focusing on generative AI in LLMs. And then I wanted to introduce this before. I'm preparing anyway some videos about SageMaker. It's a very powerful tool with a lot of functionalities. But well, obviously require how to say more training, more digging into the tool to understand all the possibilities we have there. You can do some of the stuff that is available here also in SageMaker, but again, this is a fully managed service, serverless. You don't need to worry about creating infrastructures, sizing the servers, nothing. You just create the prompt, send the request, receive the answer, and process it. And for many cases, many scenarios where you just want to pay for a service, is good enough, good quality. Again, you can integrate it with different commercial and non-commercial models. So well, is an offer that at least we need to explore, and in many cases, depending where you are, which cloud provider is the main in your setup, is something that definitely we can choose, because as any other cloud provider had very good quality and easy to use. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much for watching, and if you like, as I say every time in all my videos, if you like the content, just give me a like, and if you are not subscribed to the channel, it's just time to do it. Thank you very much. See you soon.